Alright, so I'm going to be reading poems from my chapbook, Heaven Below, a cover poem, and a newer piece of work. So we'll start right with the chapbook. Heaven Below. Because we know dirt, but we don't know earth. Because we know trees, but we don't know forest. Because we know haze, but we don't know air. Because we know sprinklers, but we don't know rain. Because we know housing, but we don't know homes. Because we know sirens, but we don't know aid. Because we know welfare, but we don't know reform. Because we know libation, but we don't know tears. Because we know bodegas, but we don't know marquetas. Because we know the game, but we don't know the rules. Because we know the block, but we don't know the world. For all this, we pray to heaven above. For all this, we pray for heaven below. Unsolved crimes perpetrated by invisible men as reported by an unreliable witness. No one bothered to call 9/11. Name who set off the long fuse of neglect. Report the fire with no smoke or flame. Drop dime on who stole the plumbing and glass. Rat out the man who left the explosives. Spot who set the controlled demolition. But I saw it. Saw it when the deed went down. Happened right in the middle of my Jones. Between the nod and the drip, white ghost came down. Woke up to find a bomb was dropped on us. The neighborhood now a playground of snap support beams and a sandbox of bone dust. The crime scene wiped clean with the blood of bricks. How much for the building? Tenants optional. We wait for the building to grow quiet. We hear copper pipes pulled like slow taffy from the walls. We wait for the building to grow quiet. We feel the limestone frames torn like a stubborn tendon. We wait for the building to grow quiet. We pretend to be asleep even with our shoes on. We wait for the building to grow quiet. We pack an emergency suitcase by the window. We wait for the building to grow quiet. We pray for warmth, but guard against fire. We wait for the building to grow quiet. What the landlord said. I've only met one honest arsonist, hands rougher than the back of a matchbook. Every time we shook on a deal, I wondered if he chose his own hands, if he picked them out for himself, looked into a store window and saw them there. Hands, gravel, cold, proud, steady under duress, no hesitation, no conscience, all business and guaranteed to help you sleep at night. Once, he held on to my handshake for a second longer, pulling me in closer, and I knew better. Knew he started out all pure pink prune with soft hair and jelly limbs, except for his fist, worn sandpaper red. Ash Wednesday. As you enter with smoke, as you enter with accelerant, as you enter with perfume, with gasoline, with flint, with spice, your mouth full of ritual, your mouth full with song, your mouth full of despair, your mouth full in praise, in resignation, in hosanna, hosanna in the highest, your house of air, your house of wisp, your house of wisdom, your house of ash, your house of ascension, your house of song, of sage, of sweetgrass, of smoke, of rags, of paper, of proper archways, blocked archways, gated archways, shut for good, for now, forever, forgiveness, for this weakness, this willingness to accept this smoke, this prayer, this test, this fate, this lift, this dust, this. So for every reading, I like to do a cover poem, you know, because there's a lot of people who inspire me all the time. We have a really big bookshelf at the house, and it's getting bigger. So like, and this is Bilingual Hoes by Victor Hernandez Cruz. He's a New Rican poet that came out here. He was published by Random House at like 19, and then came out to live in the Bay Area. And this book is pretty heavy duty, and I found it for like a buck in the San Francisco Public Library. So, you know, look around and like grab stuff. So, The Four Corners by Victor Hernandez Cruz. The first corner has become a bodega, whose window is full of plátanos, who have traveled miles to rest in that reality, green with splashes of black running down their spines. The other corner had a restaurant, a crab running out the door, speaking, "You can't write about my belly unless you taste it." The other, third corner found a group of friends singing. They became clocks with their asun, sun, 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 subabara. The last and final corner is where I stand, like a fool, making this up. So I'm going to read what we in New York like to call the new shit. This is like a freshly written poem. It's about like 2 weeks old, so that's pretty new shit-ish, you know, in terms of where we come from. It's going to be my last poem. Thank you again to Michael and everyone here at Barbershop Reading for inviting me to read. It's a real pleasure, especially to be with Barbara, which is always fun, because that way we can, you know, get through the toll quicker on the bridge. A century of writing, 100 words on where my writing's been, where it's from, where it's heading. Project, sentiment, apart, meant, coded, shaded, torn, mixed, warped. This, respected, accented, didactic. Scribe, bomber, lyric, eclectic, reflective. Recluse, reckless, misused, foolish, dervish. Strap hanger, traveler, gatherer, listener. Bitten, biter, appropriator, mediator. Denied, maligned, sullied, gully, gunning. Target, shooter, acclaim, untamed. Rename, complaint, complicated, constrained. New Yorican, aesthetic, directed, brute. Art space, reclaim, disdain, rename, Loisaya. Same old, UA, TDK, shade, fiend. Rock, steady, rock him, biggie, willie. Pietri, Algarin, Mikey, Amiri, Americano. BX, back, streets, life, lived. Puerto Rican, story stitching, loco, lalo. Papi, mami, comai, compai. Come, mierda. Shit, talker, pop, locker, break, beat, repeat, play, rewind, remind. Scribble, scratch, smear, soil, toil. Thank you, everybody.